third kind of pollution, that is air pollution. Again, the first causes, the first reason behind it is particulated matter. This one can be emitted by various combustion methods, various kind of combustion that are done in the industries, or it may be the automobile fuel combustion, it may be household fuel combustion. So basic reason for this particulated matter, that is combustion, that may be the industrial combustion, fuel combustion, petroleum combustion, or you can write automobile fuel combustion. This particulated matter can be evolved from the volcanic eruptions and other kind of natural disasters, by soil erosion also, smog, the forest fire also. So these are also the reason behind it. We use various kind of chemicals like CFC. That is used in various ways. It's chlorofluorocarbon. These are used as the cooling agent in AC and refrigerator. It's also used as the propellant in rockets. It's also used in fire extinguisher. Various halogens are used. This is the main source for air pollution, and that cause ozone depletion. Just like that, the various kind of combustion produce CO2, which is the main source for greenhouse effect. In the partial combustion, SO2, SO3, CO, different nitrogen oxide, these also come out and they will cause acid rain. So in different way, air is polluted, and the severe effects are just before of us in the way of greenhouse effect, acid rain, ozone depletion. In our lecture, we will take ozone depletion, which directly harm biota. So right now, the point regarding to ozone depletion. It's also known as ozone hole. What do you mean by ozone hole? It's decline in the thickness of ozone layer. Now, where ozone layer is found in our atmosphere? If you study about our atmosphere, it can look like this. If it's Earth's surface and it's space, then the layers which are considered in our atmosphere, these are following. The first layer that is nearer to Earth is troposphere, later on stratosphere, after that mesosphere, then ionosphere, and after that we will talk about the exosphere, in which basically helium etc. are formed, helium, hydrogen. This is about troposphere. Second layer is stratosphere. Third one is mesosphere. Fourth one is, you can say, thermosphere or ionosphere. And the last one is exosphere. In the stratosphere, there is a layer which protects us from the sun radiation. This layer is known as ozone layer. which is found approximate 20 to 26 kilometer high from the ceiling. Its thickness is near about 5 kilometer. But the depletion in the thickness, that is known as ozone hole or ozone depletion. This ozone hole is first of all seen over Antarctica. It's largest over there. It's near about 27 million square kilometer long over Antarctica. This one is first of all seen in September 2003. So basically, now point is how ozone is formed and how it protects us from ultraviolet radiations. Basically, what happened there? In the ozone layer, O2, as it comes in the contact with UV rays, it absorbs the heat energy that is found in ultraviolet rays. It's absorbed by oxygen, and later on that is break down into nascent oxygen. This nascent oxygen is hyperreactive, as we know, and that is bonded with oxygen again, and in the presence of UV rays, that will form ozone. So exactly in the way of chemistry, you can understand that basically you can write this reaction like this. Thrice of O2 will form twice of O3 in the presence of UV rays. Earlier this equation is found in the equivalent manner. The same concentration of oxygen will form ozone. The forward and backward reaction work similarly. But what we say, CFC is the main pollutant that cause ozone depletion there. What is CFC? Right now we will look about this. CFC is chlorofluorocarbon. That means a carbon. This is methane. If I replace these hydrogen from chloride and fluoride, then you will form chlorofluorocarbons. Then the various chlorofluorocarbon that can be formed by methane, these can like this, CF3Cl, CF2Cl2, CFCl3. These all are chlorofluorocarbon formed by methane. In the presence of ultraviolet rays, they will emit nascent chlorine. They get condensed there, and in the presence of ultraviolet rays, they will emit nascent chlorine, or you can say active. Just like nascent oxygen, it's also hyperreactive. It will react with ozone there and degrade it into oxygen, again in the presence of ultraviolet rays. Now active chlorate will form after degradation, and it will do the same phenomena of just like the active chlorate. It will do the same phenomena. That means it will again degrade ozone into oxygen, and again active chlorine will generate. That means now you can understand only a single chlorine that is sufficient for the degradation of ozone layer, because it will form the chain reaction, and one after one it will again just like this. Is this active chlorine is liberated out, it's responsible for the degradation of ozone layer. It will form active chlorate, and again active chlorate will do the same phenomena. Active chlorine is generated, and it will follow the first reaction again. So basically, if active chlorine is there, then ozone will definitely degrade. So the backward reaction takes place faster than forward, and ultimately oxygen is continuously forming there. So right now the thickness of ozone is going to degrade, and because of that it's unable to trap all the kind of ultraviolet radiations. Such a kind of harmful radiations are right now coming towards Earth, and they cause various kind of mutation in us. So they can damage our nucleic acid, and it's responsible for the extinction of different kind of species. Next, they also inhibit photosynthesis, which is done in planktons, phytoplanktons. They cause also adverse effect on our food chain. They decrease the functioning of immune system by modification as mutation there. They also increase the different kind of skin cancers and eye diseases, basically cataract. So these are quite harmful to us. To prevent all these kind of pollution like ozone hole, we have to take one action, that CFC should be banned. And the other factor which are responsible to cause air pollution, we have to ban them also. To prevent ozone depletion, we have to take one more step, stop air pollution and stop the use of such a kind of substances. Promotes afforestation. If we promote plantation of trees, then we can promote our life also, because we know very well these are green lungs. They can purify the air. They can also hold the soil. They can also raise the water table. So basically, by the plantation, we can prevent all kind of pollution and we can also increase our survival. Thank you all.